Forecast with meteorologist Hannah Messier.
Hannah's here now with our weather-wise question.
Our weather-wise question is about the temperatures we've seen in September, because October begins in just a few days. So here's the question. So far in September, we've had more high temperatures above normal or below normal? I'll let you guys think about that. Emily's tapping her head. And we're going to talk about our Coats for Kids campaign. It is underway and will be through the month of October. You can donate online. You can also drop off used, gently used or new coats to us. So you can drop that off at our station, or you can go to kcrg.com/care to get the other locations for our Coats for Kids campaign drop-off sites. If you want to donate some money, you can text KCRGC4K to 44321 in order to donate. So there are a couple of ways you can help kids stay warm this winter. Now, your first alert doesn't have anything cold. You won't need coats today. However, it is going to be a little bit windy. We're going to be seeing some gusts over 20 miles per hour, up to 25 miles per hour through this morning into the afternoon and evening. On our satellite and radar, we've got pretty clear skies across eastern Iowa. The clouds that are in Johnson and Cedar counties are kind of dwindling and moving to the south. On our Decorah City cam, the sun is about to rise. It's a really peaceful morning in Decorah. Temperatures are in the 60s, 61 in Cedar Rapids, 62 in Iowa City, and 55 in Decorah, with winds coming out of the north around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Now, off to our southeast, we've got a low pressure system, which is actually what is left of Hurricane Helene. Helene kind of got stuck. It got stuck over Tennessee and Kentucky, and it's just far enough to the southeast where we're not really going to see any impacts from Helene. We're not really going to see cloud cover, not going to see any rain, and Helene actually has kind of stalled out the Midwest. It's stuck over Kentucky and Tennessee, which means this cold front can't really move anywhere, and it's stuck just to our northwest, which means dry conditions for eastern Iowa, very dry and sunny for eastern Iowa between Helene and that cold front, with winds coming out of the northeast. We'll be dry all the way through the evening and overnight hours Sunday morning, waking up to sunshine. Highs today in the 80s, 82 in Washington, 84 in Waterloo, and 82 in Prairie du Chien, with that mostly sunny sky. Overnight, lows cooling into the 50s, 55 in Oskaloosa, 56 in Dubuque, and 53 in Fayette, with a clear sky. Now, it's going to be pretty warm basically through the next several days. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, but then Tuesday gets a little bit cooler, which will be a little nice, a little taste of fall on Tuesday. However, next couple of days, low 80s with that sunshine, overnight temperatures in the 50s, 69 on October 1st for Tuesday, before we warm back up into the 70s and 80s. And on that note, back to the weather-wise question, what do you guys think the answer is?
Oh, I think it's A.
I also think it's A.
You guys are right. It is A. It's just been very hot and very dry for the last month. So, yeah, so far October also looks hot and dry. But, like, I would like to remind everyone, we don't control the weather. We just forecast the weather.
Don't call in and complain to us, because we can't fix it. We just tell you.
Our grass is crunchy, too.
Yeah, everybody's kind of feeling the heat and low rain. It would be nice for that to stop soon.
Yeah, just a little rain, some temperatures in the upper 60s, more than just one day on the 9-day would be nice.
Yeah.
We're crossing our fingers.
Yeah.
Maybe next week.
Well, maybe we should do a fall dance, since that'll change something.
Maybe we'll try.
Okay.
All right, thanks.